Great academics, scientists, barristers and the like are in fact quite clueless when it comes to business, and that's the reason why Nicholas was fired.
Okay, all that effort and you're just quite clueless.
Yeah, apparently so. Yeah, interesting coming from Kevin. He was quite quiet in the task, but you know, shall let the series continue to see how he goes.
There's always one that gets away, isn't there? There's always one who comes close to the sack, but it doesn't quite happen. Mm. So we're doing a little series about the one who survived against all the odds. Here's this week's.
Alex, the headlines are you were the team leader, prices were wrong, identification of product was wrong.
Did you not write Turbot on the back
of the box? I wrote Turbot after consulting people who were unable to identify it. One of those individuals was yourself.
Kev,
the red team.
What are you doing?
I feel like I've just been continuously let down by a couple of members of the team today.
There was an embarrassing sequence of events where we just had Alex in front of everyone, just, you know, bullying and blaming Nick, trying to make him scapegoat.
Let's stop dwelling on the negatives. We understand that.
Alex, a team leader who, for his living, runs sales teams, put himself forward to do, effectively, a very simple selling job, and it failed.
Well, Alex played a blinder, actually, didn't he? Because it's a poison chalice being the captain. But on the other hand, if you delegate everything, then nothing can be your fault in the end, can it? Which is essentially what happened.
Well, I think that Alex made a decision to give Nick pricing and to give Rafe labelling.
Right.
And I think if you weren't sure on that, you should have said, look, actually, do you know what? I'm not very good at maths. Pricing shouldn't be me.
Well, we saw you make a horlicks of the whole thing, you know, the boys' team generally. The girls kind of got away with it in the sense, because they weren't that much better, were they?
Oh, it's so nice to meet everyone,
finally.
We're so going to win this task, you know,
so
that, don't you?
Fishy business.
Yeah.
Quicker!
I'll take seven, yeah?
Seven
quid for two.
That's not cod.
That's not cod. I need two sea bass.
Who's just got the bloody squid? That costs money.
We have Alpha being dominant. Alpha's also the brightest star in the constellation.
Guys, I'm talking. Sorry, this is the problem. We start talking and everyone starts disappearing.
It's the beginning of the Greek alphabet. Also, the logo is easy to remember, so he wants something to remember. It looks a wee bit like a fish as well.
We want to get rid of it.
You want to get rid of it, give me 120 and you give me a proper receipt.
If 125.
125.
125.
No.
You want 125?
How much for?
125.
Yeah!
Of the girls, who did you rate then?
I liked Claire. I mean, I thought that she had a bit of a ropey start, but she pulled it round. She was quite calm under pressure. She did say to the girls, look, I'm talking, you have to listen. She tried to rein them in a bit. And the best thing she did is she worked out the money. She worked out there was a shortfall. She took half the fish and off she went, and she went to a restaurant and she sold it. And she, you know, and that's why they won. I think they had a little bit more clarity of thought, a little bit more of a plan. And once they'd made a decision, they went for it.
There was an excellent moment, I thought, in that solicitor's office. How they ended up trying to sell fish to solicitors, I know not. But this man, Sophocles, he's trying to say the sum that they're being offered is too small, but he doesn't use the word small. Oh, no, he's trying to be a bit clever.
I just think £50 is too diminutive.
I love it. So next time somebody doesn't offer you enough for a player at Birmingham, you say, that's too diminutive, I'm afraid, Mr. Jordan, or something. It was difficult, though, not to feel sorry for Michael. It's what The Apprentice does to him. It's all this bravado. And then look at him in this clip.
Simon, Ian and Lee did a fantastic job actually knocking out the product.
So I find it absolutely insulting that you don't actually include me in the group of people who sold their absolute heart out.
Michael, you did a fantastic job. I'm not insulting you at all. I've only met you all today.
Well,
what do you mean, friends? We've not forged any relationships yet.
I don't know. It just sounds very, very interesting.
Oh, shame. Poor chap.
There are about six moments in that episode where you look and you think, Michael's going to cry.
I loved Kevin for the simple reason that he seemed to think fish have breasts.
The size of the breasts on that, they're massive.
Do fish have breasts?
As far as I know, no. No.
What do they have then, instead of breasts?
Tails and a head.
But then there's Rafe. There is Rafe. Words. Always threatening. So there's Rafe. Words fail me. Words don't fail him, though. Oh, no, words. Words are his tools, don't forget.
Although one points out where one has gone wrong, one shouldn't dwell on it for so long.
People have always recognised within me a born leader.
My name's Rafe. I represent Renaissance Limited, a purveyor of fine fish.
You didn't create it, but you may have exacerbated it. There's a difference there.
I get on with prince or pauper.
You're the prince, eh?
If I am faced with a situation that may cause, you know, mere morsels to quake, I don't.
This is how I've marked, you know, a shark hamster. I've literally left with my hands bleeding. Pompous, yeah, but nothing wrong with pomposity.
Pomposity is clearly his middle name. If there's something on his CV which Sir Alan spotted, which does demonstrate that there's no one better in the world to kick pomposity into touch than Sir Alan Sugar. Have a look at this clip.
What is all this stuff about face death many times? Where have you faced death many times? Was that in the hairdressing shop?
Where did he get that hair? I don't know anybody with hair like that.
I think that, forgetting his hair for a second, I think it's really funny, you know, the bravado and then, you know, no one gets in my way. But then he wouldn't be team leader.
No.
He actually quaked in his boots when somebody said, oh, beat it. I've not managed people. I'm a manager. And they said, well, who do you manage? Oh, myself. I don't manage anybody else.
But that's a big ask in his case.
Yes, I think you're probably right, Adrian.
And we all say The Apprentice is about business, but there's one moment this week which encapsulated for me what The Apprentice is really all about. Here it is.
She's putting it askew anyway. Is that all right? Bad enough for you?
I love that critic. Is that all right? Of course it's not all right. Yes, I'd like my fish bludgeoned to death. But these are what you actually need. He had the wrong tools for the job.
No, he didn't. He was just using the wrong side. It's this way.
Sorry, just... Simon, you...